So here's our top shot, which is 130-pound Suffolk key lime, and that's got to fit up inside this 100-pound braid. And when you're looking at that there, you're thinking, well, hey, that's not going to work, but it does. You just need this device. It's a pipe needle. So it's basically a hollow needle that's going to allow us to thread this mono up inside that braid, and it's a seamless connection, and it's an extremely strong connection. In fact, it's 100%, you don't lose any line strength with it. Now the needle I've selected is an 80-pound needle, and this 130-pound is in fact not going to fit inside it. And I've gone with the 80-pound needle because it's thinner and it's going to fit up inside this nice thin hollow base braid much easier. So to make it fit, we just take a box cutter here, nice sharp blade, and we're just going to taper it down so it fits inside. So we'll rotate it around. I'm basically just making that thinner, and then if I square it off on the end, we'll just see if that's going to fit inside the needle now. Now you really want to push that in and get a nice tight jam, because you don't want that coming out when you're partway through your splice. So now we've got our mono into our needle, we start our splice. Now we don't come in through the very end, we come about an inch or 25 mil up. So we just bunch the braid up a little bit, and it allows us to get the needle in the side of the braid there. And now I'm simply just going to thread this needle all the way up inside the hollow base braid, and it's going to take that mono with it. So I've poked this pipe needle now about a meter and a half up inside, and you can see how much mono that I've got thread up inside. So at this stage we just got to take our needle out, so we just bunch the braid up again, and you can see we just poke the needle straight out the side of the fibers. We slide it out, get rid of the needle, we're finished with that. But before we slide this back up inside, we've got to make a nice fine taper. It's really important. We come back about an inch or 25 mil, and I'm just going to do the finest of gradual tapers, taking more and more of that mono away. And what I've done there is I've got that ramped down nice and smoothly. I'm just going to take a little bit of sandpaper, fine grit sandpaper. I'm just going to very carefully remove what might be any sharp edges or burrs from that. And what it also does a wee bit is it just roughs the end of the mono, so it grips nicely when it goes back inside the braid. I just slide that back up inside the braid, and there it is. That's our connection, but we've still got to do a whipping on the other end. This is where our mono ends inside the hollow braid. But before I do a whipping, I'm just pulling that down nice and tight, and I'm removing any looseness that there might be. And it's coming right back down to our spool here, which I've put on the spooler. I'm going to pull that tag end nice and tight. Now, to secure this tag end here, dental floss. I'm not very particular on my brands of dental floss, but I do like to use the double mint. Get more bites. That's not true. And to get started, we've just doubled over. We loop it back through itself. We slide it down to within about 5 mil of that tag end, and we pull it nice and tight. And then from here, we're just going to half hitch over and over again, right down the entire length of that tag end. Now the reason we've got this tag end is so all of these whippings are going to pull nice and tight over the top of that, and it gives a bit of grip for the dental floss to grip it on the end there. If we'd come up straight through the end and we didn't have that, really there's an opportunity, more of an opportunity, that that whipping will slip, can slide up. That would be a worst case scenario. So I've never had it fail doing it this way, and literally it's been tested with hundreds if not thousands of big game fish catches. Three or four more half hitches. They're just going to bite nicely into that mono. Now once I've done those, here's how I'm going to finish it off. I'm going to loop in the line, and I'm going to be winding the doubled over dental floss back up towards the whipping that I've just done. I then hold it over the top, and then I'm winding back the other way. Basically I'm unwinding this end and winding this end here up. And I'm just keeping it nice and neat with my spare finger there as I go. Now once that's there, we simply pull the tag end up. And voila, that's been whipped over. This dental floss, I find the real fine diameter and the wax on it really bites in on itself. There's no glue or anything required there. In fact, if there's any glue, it makes me more anxious that something can let go, fail. Any sudden movement under load could cause it to snap. And like I say, have never had one of these fail. Now, I've just got to wind on with 50 meters of mono, and we can finish off with a plait and tying us with a line. Thank you.